Hello, it's me again. I'm Nafith. In this short video, we'll talk about the AirWave version 8.3, how to download and install it. So basically, AirWave is a major platform, and I will specifically focus on the instant AP initial communication. So we're going to show you the AirWave download OVA. You could download an ISO image if you would like to, but I chose the option of OVA. How to install this one on the ESXi version 7, instant AP organization string, what does it mean, and how will that enable, of course, the instant AP or the cluster to join and to automate the creation of folders and group. So what are AirWave groups and folders, and I would like then to show you quickly how users have been created automatically by the fact that the organization string as an option has been specified in the AirWave section of the instant AP cluster. And then we'll verify when you add a new access point to the cluster. The new access point will automatically join the cluster without any effort from your side. It will be part of the cluster in this case, and there is no need to do anything from your site. First of all, you need to download AirWave. So you sign in into the Aruba support portal. Then you go to software and documentation, and then search for AirWave. You can search if you like. And obviously we need only software in this case. We will download the latest one. You can download as ISO format or OVA. OVA is the easiest way to go. So you download and install this one. Now in the ESXi, you can deploy that OVA. Just call it AirWave 8.3, so that's the version. That's the one. Just accept, and I connect to this network. Now the installation is complete. The username for the Linux will be root, and the password will be admin. And we're going to start the process for the installation. Now we have to go through, if you would like, change the time and date. We can change the time zone. So here in Europe, number 8, number 7. And then number 8, which is United Britain, UK. We're happy with that. Number 1, yes. And then we go finish. That will start the process of the installation. It will take a bit of time. You can see more details if you have press Control Alt F9. And you can go and see list details F1. That will take you back to this one. We're going to wait a little bit. So now the recovery, AMP recovery, we press enter, we leave it as is. AMP admin, that's the main username, that's the command line one, which is basically the AirWave admin. And the password, we're going to select the password for this, confirm it. Now we're going to set the settings. So we select by numbers. Number 1, IP address. Then we press number 2, mask. Gateway, number 3. DNS, number 6. We don't need to set number 5 and 4 and 5 IPv6. So number 6, gate DNS. And we're happy with that. Then we will press number 9 to commit changes. At this prompt, we're going to say Y for yes. So we can give it a name now. We just give it AirWave, simple name. I don't have certificate. We're going to say no in here. And then it will take a bit of time to finish the installation. So we go to the end and we're going to press enter to continue. There we go. Now if we log in, we log in as AMP admin. And password is the password we set. That should log you in into this command line. Now you have these options. Obviously, you can go and do command line. We don't normally do command line, but you can if you would like to do so. So the installation is ready now to be used as a GUI interface. When we go to the GUI, by default, the password, the username is admin. And the password will be the same password we have set when we have done this installation. For example, if you would like to manage users, you type number 5, and that will give you the user menu. You can reset the password from command line, add file, configure password, age limit, add emergency account, AP recovery account, and you can go to advanced. So many options you have. And you can unlock, if you like, the user. Sometimes get locked, so you can unlock the user, which is the last option, number 6 here, for example, right? So again, the web user is admin, and the password for that is the same password you set it in the command line on the console. When you SSH to the AirWave, you can SSH in this case, and I'll show you. Quit for Q for quit. And now you can SSH AMP admin and then admin 1. You don't have to enable it. It's already enabled by default. You can disable it basically on the other hand. Yeah. Now we can web access the AirWave. So that's AirWave admin 1. Now by default, you don't have, you have 90 days grace period for the license. You have by default 90 days grace period for the license. So you go home, you will find a grace period expires in 90 days. So you can use it fully functional for 90 days, after which you have to enter the license. Now you can download an evaluation license. That's good for also 90 days from the support portal. What we're going to do now, we will add the first instant AP to the installed AirWave. So we have done the installation. It is ready to receive AP. So multiple options, three options. DHCP option 43, option 60. That's a way to add the access point to the AirWave. Activate, or the option that is local interface. What we are going to do in this video is the local interface. So we looked into the instant AP, you can see this. I went to configuration system and then admin. So admin usually looks like this when you go to system. So in the dashboard, first of all, you go to configuration system and then you expand the admin. There's a section in the admin says AirWave. So you expand it and you enter the organization. We are going to, of course, based on your setup, but this is just a demo purpose. I'm going to type wisdain colon. The next character is colon. We'd say demo. And the AirWave is 10.254.1.22. And this key is only, the key is only entered here, shared key. We'll only enter it here. Of course, you will use stronger one, but that's for demo purpose. Now, what will happen in AirWave, that will create a group that's called wisdain. The group is meant for compliance. And then if it is full control, then you can do the config from the group, either as a GUI group or as a template base. and then that create a folder called Wizlane and a subfolder in that called demo. Now the group, there's no subgroup. It will be folder under the default top folder that's called top. And then a subfolder called demo where the access point and any other in the cluster will be added to that specific location. So we're going to start with one AP and we will discover that AP in AirWave. So we're going to go save now. That will try to join the AirWave now. If we log into AirWave with a username admin and password, whatever we have selected. Now what will happen if you check with AirWave, we logged in with the admin, password is the same as we have configured. And you notice there's a folder called Wizlane and there is a subfolder called demo. And notice that in the list, you will see there is a group called Wizlane. That's something happens dynamically thanks to the organization string as an option. You don't have to, but that's an option that will automate the creation of the group or groups and the group or and folder or folders. Now the other thing is what they've done, what happens actually, these so the group has been created, the two folders have been created, plus there will be a role that would be generated. So the role is called Wizlane admin. It's not enabled by default, but this is to control access to folders and other stuff, and we're going to look at that one in a few minutes. So this Wizlane admin has access to the folder that where the devices belong to. That's a role actually, and then the user would be the same name. So that automated the creation of a role and a user. Now, the device is listed as a new device, and this is the one we have our Wizlane here. That's a group and the folder that belongs to its demo, a subfolder. And we can say we need to accept it, so we're gonna add the device. You don't have to specify anything, to be quite honest, because it will follow what the organization string has dictated. So that will go down, not down in a sense that the access point is down, but from the communication perspective between access point and so the wind and the instant AP, so for the settings to be applicable. Now once that's up, you will notice that the access point is listed under the folder. So if you go to devices and list, normally what happens really, you'll see the device under the folder that is a subfolder of, depends on the organization string. So here we see demo, the device has been added. It will update the configuration, that's fine, but this is the virtual controller functionality. You see the name, set me up the last 24 bits of the MAC address, and that's of the VC, and the name of the access point actually is the MAC address of Ethan 0. So you see them listed here. Let's move from unknown or something we haven't seen to verifying, and few seconds time that will become good. So now it's good and you can see two devices are up. Now I'm logged in as admin, remember. And if I look at the devices, I can see a list of devices. I can expand the folder. I can see the list. I go to the top and expand all devices. Of course, there are seven of them are new, but let's say I can add all of them. That's fine. So let me add all of them. So while they're being added, we can look at devices and we can see from the top folder, we can see I can expand and I can see all devices because our devices are good. Right, so the point I'm trying to make here, this admin can see everything. Now we have seen that a user and the role have been created. So if we go to the role here, that role is allowing access point, allowing visibility in, as a read only. Look at that is allowing access to the folder that is supposed to be accessible. So we have a look. Let's enable the role, and the role name is with lane admin and can manage device as a read only. Notice the top folder for that role is with lane. Look, it's with lane. This is where the devices belong to. So there's a subfolder for this one, it's called demo. And I have just enabled the role right now. I left everything is as is, and I'm gonna just say okay and save it. So yeah, we need to supply the password for this. And we're gonna save that, yeah? Now we go to the user that has been created and with lane admin, so click on this. I'm gonna just, this username, assign the role and the user enabled, yes. And we will set the password for that user. Just one more thing, we need to just make sure there's no space here. So just we will remove the space and we'll call it with lane admin. And we have set the password for that. We're gonna log in with that specific one. Now we log out. Now, what do we see? Look at the top, you'll see two devices only, nothing else. And if you click on devices, you'll see, you only see the top folder that is assigned to that specific user. So you might have multiple locations and maybe each location have, maybe each country might have their own admins. We can create and then we can set the view to that specific folder or folders that these users can have access to. And notice in the group list, they only see with lane. That's what's supposed to be seen by that specific role. Yeah. So this how, you know, how by default things natively controlled in here. When a new AP becomes member of the stack, member of the cluster, you don't have to do anything. Basically, it will automatically be added to the cluster and it would show up in AirWave dynamically. So now we have two APs. One of them is the virtual control, as you can see, and which is this one with the asterisk is listed. And the other one has joined and picked up all settings from that AP or from the cluster, the existing one. So natural behavior of a new AP or instant AP added, it will automatically be added to AirWave without any effort from your side. Thank you for watching this video and I will see you in future videos. Thank you very much.